Hi everybody, in this video we'll see how we can estimate the undrained shear strength of clay using just some data on clay plasticity. And we're going to look at this example when we have clay which is normally consolidated, and we take the sample at the depth of 5 meters, and we know that the groundwater level is 1 meter below the ground surface. So I can just schematically show it here. So this is the ground surface. So clay is here. This is 5 meters. And we have a groundwater level right here, which is 1 meter below the ground surface. What we also know is the liquid limit and the plastic limit of this clay. And we also know the unit weight, which is 19 kilonewton per cubic meters. So what we're asked to find is the undrained shear strength of clay. And we're gonna do it using this formula. So there is another way to do that. We can roughly estimate it from this table, which is shown here. It's after Skepton 1957. So now let's see how we can find this undrained shear strength of soil. You'll see that one of the values that we need to know is effective stress. And we're going to find this effective stress at the depth of 5 meters. So first we'll find normal stress, which is 5 meters times the unit weight of soil. That will give us 95 kPa. Then we will find water pressure. So water pressure will be 5 meters minus 1 meter times 9.81, which is the unit weight of water. That will give us 39.2 kPa. The effective stress is the difference between total stress and water pressure. It's 95 minus 39.2 will give us 55.8 kPa. Okay, so another value that we need to find is plasticity index. If you know this, and if you have watched my previous videos about soil plasticity, you know that plasticity index is liquid limit minus plastic limit. So in this case will be 45 minus 31 will give us 14. And now we can use the formula to find the undrained shear strength. So it will be, I'm going to rewrite it, 0.11 plus 0.0037 times plasticity index, which is 14, and multiply by the effective vertical stress, which is 55.8. So it should give us about 9 kPa, which is the undrained shear strength of this clay. Now what we can do is we can check in the table and see if it makes sense or not. So we have the plasticity index, which is less than 20, so it's going to be a sort of low range of here in this column. And then we have effective stress about 55, so it should be somewhere again like a low range of this value, so it's going to be from 9 to 18, and probably like more to the lowest value, which is 9. So that actually gives a good correlation with the table presented here. Well, that's it for today. Thanks for watching this video. Don't forget to like it and subscribe to the channel. Have a nice day. Bye.